So just start working at the base and start working up the base, cleaning off the trunk. So you can see the trunk. Little bits at a time here. Okay. This over here. And so, like I said, you just kind of fold some of this back and say, okay, you know, what's going on with this branch? See how I got this big branch here? Do I want that or not? And you probably want to look at it from all sides. Like if I take this apart, I'm going to see more trunk through here. And you can start by taking a little bit of it off. And what I usually try and go for is separation, right? So you can get kind of, you know, some areas where you've got stuff and some that you don't. That's this thing just needs really pruning up. So like here is another little area where this is growing up into here. So let's turn it over this way for a second. Excuse me. So like I want to see this coming down through here, but it's right now it's kind of all cluttered here with these other things. So if you look here, if I trim these back a little bit, use the other scissors on these because it, so now we're getting some separation through here. And you have to think, you know, in the future, do you want some stuff coming off this side or you want it, you know, one technique with some of these bonsais is to do them all on one side so they look kind of windswept. So once, just like if you see at the coast, the stuff facing in the wind, the trees tend to be pretty bare and then you've got growth on the other side. So that's another thing that we could potentially do with this. Let's see here. Take some of this smaller stuff out here so we can start seeing a little more trunk to it. And each one does kind of have like a little character of their own. So like, you know, where the main branches want to go and that sort of thing.
Yeah.
Okay. So now if you look really carefully up here, this is growing up through there. I don't really like that. So this guy's, take that guy out. Probably this guy out. Now we're starting to get a little more of the trunk through there. And this has got a really nice S-shaped trunk, so I kind of want to trim a lot of this back just so I can see more of it. Still not seeing all the trunk here, so I'm gonna take one of these out here. Just like that. So this is kind of growing up here. I probably cut that down to keep this kind of in a swooping fashion like that. Just take a little at a time and then fold your branches back and, you know, what are they doing here? See where it's kind of taking you. The other thing is I like to keep them up off the ground because one, if you get these down on the in the dirt, they'll kind of rot. So I usually trim up too. On the bottom here.
Interesting.
Just come along the bottom and cut that up. So I haven't even decided if I want these yet. I may just take those out. It's kind of folding it back and picturing what the tree's going to look like with it or without it.
I think it'd be interesting to take them out. It'd be kind of a big bold move, though.
Well, let's see. You want to be careful about, some of the stuff will start growing back. You'll get more of these little starts. So you can grow one out again, but it's going to take time if you cut it,
mm-hmm.
right? And you don't know which way it's going to really necessarily even want to go once you get another start. You can take wire and train these,
mm-hmm.
copper wire, and bend it the way you want it to go.
Yeah.
So there's that. So you're starting to get some separation here, and you get layers to it. So I'm going to just take that off. Yes. I'm just going to take that guy off. That's better, I think. And you start kind of creating some balls, and what you'll have is you'll have new growth like this that comes out on the top, and you got to kind of control that, like how far out do you want it to go. Just real quick. So look down underneath here. You see these little wispy things down on the bottom here? Okay, I'm going to cut those. Okay. Same thing here. Get rid of the stuff on the bottom. Okay. Now, we're really still crowded in through here. Got all sorts of stuff going on in here, so you gotta see what we want in there and what don't we. I kind of feel like taking these out will get us a little better. Okay. Going on in here. Got a lot of stuff in here, so. Usually, again, prune the bottom. And then prune the top here a little bit to try and get some separation between these layers.
Mm-hmm.
I still think we probably. See, I like this nice S shape that we have going up through here.
Yeah, I like
it. That one. See, this one's kind of hanging down, but we could take some copper wire, wrap it, and train it to go up a little bit if we want to do. Be the tree. Yeah, it kind of helps sometimes. A lot of people don't know this, but if you actually play a little like Buddhist Zen music in the background, it actually helps you.
Helps you focus.
Well, you know, it helps you and it helps the tree. So okay. This little guy, okay. I don't need that guy.
Yeah.
And take that guy out. Comes to the top here. I'm gonna set this down on the floor so I can see a little better. So same thing here. You look straight, look down on it if you can. It looks like a big canopy here, but you might want to give this some separation as well. So I come in here a little bit and prune like one area back from the other just a little bit. So we got a little bit of separation here now. See, then we can start seeing that, seeing a little more of the trunk here again. Personally, I like to see the contortion of it. That gave me a lot better separation underneath here for these guys. And through here. So we get more layers to this.
Yeah.
Take this guy out too. This is what I mean. You just kind of hold one back and see, you know, how's it going to look with or without it. And you may decide you want it, then keep it. Just prune it a little bit. Okay, so layer, and we're just getting to just a few branches here and there that we want to keep. Probably give this a little bit of a trim up here. I think I could probably go. That's probably all I'll do with this one for right now. I'm going to give this one a little bit of... This little thing here. Go. I would probably train this one up a little with some copper wire because it's hanging down on top of this. And I'd like to have it kind of up a little This little copper would do that. Not sure about this guy. I'll leave him for now. And so what I'll keep letting this thing do, you'll get new growth out here on the side, and I'll let this keep growing out this way,
mm-hmm.
just like this guy is out here.
Yeah.
So. Keep thinking to yourself, be the tree. Be the tree.
Alright.
Let me get a little back here. Over here. There she is. I think we're gonna leave it at that for now.